Hey guys, it's Shonda Hunt here, and today I'm coming to you with a demo request video to show how to combine as well as subtract alpha mats from each other. So let's go through them. I went ahead, there's no one way to add or subtract an alpha mat together. There's actually multiple ways. So I did create these little setups here. And I have, actually it looks like I have this one twice, we'll just delete that. So I have these operations where we, where I show how the operation looks. So let's just cycle through. There are different ones. There's the merge max, merge over, merge screen, and then the channel merge. So the channel merge is a node which is called, if you hold, press tab and type in channel, you'll see the channel merge appear. So the channel merge is just a node itself that you can use to combine your alpha channels. Now, we can also combine, you know, other channels using this operation, this node, but for now we're just discussing the alpha channels. So we have that, and then we have the screen operation, which if you can see, they actually look the same. So all of these over operations will produce the same results. They're just different operations to get to that point. We have the merge over, and then we have the merge max. So these are some examples of merge operations in the channel merge node that you can use, and these are some ways that you can combine your alpha mats. I do want to note, usually I did do these setups where I just use one merge node, but more often I'm using multiple ones to bring in my mats together because I want to have a little more control. So I will go ahead and just use multiple channel merges or multiple merge nodes to combine my mats instead of just using one. And that's just because I like to just see what's coming in at what point, and I don't want to guess which input is which, or you know, if you're using roto shapes, you know, it's not so clear what you're going to be seeing outputted. So I like to simply use these different, this stacking method, I would say. So that is how you would, you know, combine some mats together. And let's go through how we would subtract some mats. So there are some different options. We have the merge stencil. We have, so I'll just show you, I have this alpha mat and then I'm subtracting that and then I'm going to subtract that. So there's the stencil operation, and again, this is just your merge node set to whichever operation we're going to choose. We have the merge out, and then we have the merge minus. Now, one thing I do want to discuss before I end the video is, usually when we're working and we're compositing, we want our B pipe to be the downstream pipe, and we want to bring things in through our A pipe. If you do not know, you can actually click on your node and press Shift and X. And if you can see, these inputs are swapping. So the B and the A input are swapping. So when you want to just quickly go through and make sure your inputs are correct, you can use that keyboard shortcut. Now for the merge out, as well as the merge minus operation, I do have my A pipe going down, which I can also just change. It works, this operation works a little different than you might think, which is why I have it set up this way. So first I'll just show you the result. So we want to subtract, of course, this pyramid from this mat. So that's what we want to do, but we actually would have to reverse our workflow a little bit from the way that we would think about it, you know. So normally we would have it the way I had it set up before, where we had this one upstream. But again, it is best, and it's kind of a best practice, to try to always keep your B pipe going downstream so you don't get mixed up with any bounding box issues or anything else down the line. So this is how we would, you know, swap these over, and it's the same thing with the out. So we have it again where we do want to remove or stencil out this pyramid from that mat, but for our workflow and to make sure we're always working in the best way, we would just switch them over, and let's see. If we switch the input, you'll see this is what you get. So if you're ever working or trying to combine some mats and using a certain note, and you see that your result is not exactly what you were looking for, go ahead and switch your inputs and see if you get something that you're looking for, like the result that you're hoping for. And if not, then just try a different operation.